Gastroesophageal reflux disease, or GERD, is a chronic condition of the stomach contents backing up into the esophagus. The causes include both physical and lifestyle factors. By the end of this video, you will be able to explain how GERD develops, the consequences, and identify the causes of it. GERD is normally a product of the lower esophageal sphincter weakening or pressure in the stomach being higher than the esophagus. Either of these problems can lead to stomach contents backing up into the esophagus. The problem with reflux is the esophagus cannot handle the high acidity of the stomach contents. Hydrochloric acid in the stomach is very acidic. It has to be, so it can perform its many functions, including denaturing protein. Since all cells are made up of protein, this can be a problem. The cells of the stomach lining are protected by mucus, but the esophagus does not have this protection. So when the highly acidic stomach contents back up into the esophageal cells are at risk. These can produce symptoms such as coughing, nausea or vomiting, and pain that may be a burning sensation or pressure in the chest. With repeated or prolonged high acidity in the esophagus, it leads to inflammation, ulcerations, bleeding, scarring, strictures, or stenosis, and risk of cancer. One of the misconceptions about reflux is that it is caused by too much stomach acidity. While this can occur, it is a rare problem. It is also not associated with consuming high acid foods. Note, all of the foods we consume have a lower acidity than hydrochloric acid produced in the stomach. This means that no matter what you eat, the stomach will make the contents more acidic. As mentioned previously, the etiology is primarily due to a weak lower esophageal sphincter or too much pressure in the stomach. So let's take a look at what causes increased pressure in the stomach and a weakened sphincter. There are some medical conditions like abdominal fluid, delayed gastric emptying, and pregnancy that we have minimal control over. But we have several factors like overeating, lying down after meals, obesity, and tight-fitting pants that put unnecessary pressure on the stomach, pushing the contents up into the esophagus. There are some changes to anatomy that can lead to reflux as well. With a hiatal hernia, a portion of the stomach is above the sphincter, so there is nothing to keep the contents down. A weakened lower esophageal sphincter, known as the LES, is also a big problem because it is not able to remain closed after eating. There are several medications that weaken the LES. Those drugs may be a necessary part of a person's health, though. Dietary and lifestyle factors that we have better control of include smoking and consuming alcohol, caffeine, high-fat foods, mint, and chocolate. Yes, I know, those are not the foods you wanted to hear, the problems for reflux. But the truth of the matter is that a large amount of GERD is related to our eating habits and lifestyle. As you look at the causes of GERD, you should be thinking about how this will translate to diet and lifestyle modifications to treat it.